All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Mike Power. He's the CEO of Silver Range Resources. And Mike, it's always great to see you. How are you?
Good. Thanks, Steve. Great to see you.
Yeah, so news release out today talking about a number of things and basically providing a real update on some of your projects. And first off, I want to ask you about the Bellehelen Project because, you know, what you've done in the past with projects, you get them to a point, move them along. You've done this with Bellehelen as well.
Yeah, well, we optioned our Bellehelen project to a private BC company that's looking to list on one of the stock exchanges. We've ended it for 500,000 Canadian, a 2% royalty, and a $2 an ounce success fee or defined resource fee. So, you know, it's a deal for the times. As you're well aware, it's pretty quiet, at least in the gold exploration side, difficult to raise money. It's been challenging to option projects. You know, we were very happy to see Headwater did their deal recently, but that's been the first big deal in Nevada in many months. So we were happy also to be able to do this deal and looking forward to having them work out at Bellehelen. It's a great project.
All right. Well, we'll look forward to following that story as well. Now, while we've got you here, we should update a couple of other things that are going on with the company as well. Let's go to Steptoe. Tell me a little bit about what's going on there.
Right. Well, our Steptoe project is in eastern Nevada. It's just north of Ely. It's in what they call the Eastern Carbonate Trend. This is east of the, you know, the major Carlin-esque trends where they have these huge gold mines. And they've been finding mines out there, that notably the Long Canyon mine that Barrick's running is north of where we are. There's the Kinsley deposit that Copar is working on. And just north of us, Centerra's got a big project going. It's kind of a land of the giants. You see the big company stomping around there trying to find another Carlin deposit. So, you know, kind of a good spot for a prospect generator. Yeah. We've been working at Steptoe since 2016. It's a big area, and we've been doing sort of general reconnaissance throughout the area, running stream sediments. And last year, we ran some ridge and spur soil surveys, where you just kind of walk down all the ridges and take soil samples and hope you hit something. And we did in one spot. And this spring, we went back to follow it up. We had some high soils there. And this spring, when we went back and had a look, the boys discovered a very impressive jasperoid. Now, in the Carlin deposit world, the jasperoid is a silicified brecciated limestone. It's all crumbled up and then flooded with quartz. And that's what we found. And the really cool thing about this one is there isn't a sample tag. There's no evidence this was ever touched by anybody. It's in a rather, it's a remote, rugged area in the Steptoe Range. So it's a tough place to get into. So consequently, this thing's unexplored. It runs for about 700 meters. It's 2 to 10 meters wide. And we knocked grab samples off of it, carrying anomalous gold up to 4 feet at 1.97 grams per ton. So the thing is definitely gold bearing, and it's really unexplored. So we're waiting rather impatiently for our soils. We just have the grab samples now, but the labs are backed up with soils for 9 weeks and counting. But once we have a look at the soils over this anomaly, we'll be able to have a better picture whether just how significant this is. But our hopes are high and our fingers are crossed. And if something pans out here, we'll be back.
All right. Well, we'll look forward to that. Also, I want to ask you about East Goldfield. This is one you and I have talked about in the past. What's been happening there over the last little while?
Yeah, well, a lot of things. And so, you know, Goldfield is a fabulously rich camp. I can look out my window here, and there's about a mile of tailings and a half a dozen headframes poking up through them. And it produced about 4.2 million ounces of 17 grams. So it's one of the richer gold camps in North America. And parts of it were extremely rich. You know, there was one 50-ton boxcar came out of there that had 25,000 ounces of gold in it. So it was like super jewelry-grade stuff. That's in the Goldfield Main District, and it was mined out continuously until 1958 and intermittently thereafter. Since then, Kennecott found a deposit north of town, and they had to move the highway around it. And then there's another deposit called McMahon Ridge. And things ran pretty quietly here and kind of until especially the 2010s, because Waterton came in and bought the whole district up, and it's been dead. Now, in 2018, you know, since we're here, we better have a look around. And lo and behold, we found some very interesting ground on the east end of Goldfield. If you look at the Goldfield district, it looks like a frying pan on its side. It's really well defined by the USGS aster imagers, the hot red colors in the alteration maps are where the rocks were cooked. On the west side of the frying pan, the big circular part, that's where these three deposits are. And we have the handle. So we optioned our property to ATAC in a couple of years ago. And they went out and they did a great job on the surface sampling. They found some new showings that the old timers had never seen and never sampled. One of them ran 8 meters at 4.2 grams, you know, and in an area that where there's well over 100 workings. There's an old mine out there. It goes down about 500 feet, worked on three levels. So anyway, they worked on it. They did a great job on the surface. They drilled. They weren't happy with the results. And last winter, in February, they came to us on a Tuesday and they said, you know, surface, the drill results weren't what we hoped for. We're going to have to give you the property back. And on Wednesday, there was a staking crew from Mexico in here, staking all around town. And there was a press release that Centerra had bought the whole district from Waterton. And things have really changed since then. There's three, going to be five drill rigs here in town meetings. And Centerra has told all of us locals that their intention is to explore very intensely here for several years before they make a production decision, because they want to right size any mine that they make. And they really recognize the potential of the district. So that's music to our ears. Consequently, we're going to ramp up efforts at East Goldfield. ATAC showed us the way with they had a very innovative surface sampling technique that really worked. We're going to apply that. We have a small pack stack drill and we're going to take that out, poke a few holes in. So I guess this is more of a pre-boarding announcement that there's news coming out of our East Goldfield project. And we figure it should be a real priority for this fall.
Yeah, it sounds like it's starting to really rev up there, which is obviously good news. As you mentioned, it's been a little slow there lately. So, it's been slow.
Yeah, and this is not a rich town. You know, people here are really looking forward to seeing something happen.
All right. Well, we wish the best for that for sure. Mike, thanks so much for the update. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Steve. So long.
All right. There's Mike Power, the CEO of Silver Range Resources.